Cześć, cześć! Knowing a few words in native language is usually beneficial when visiting a new country. In this video you will find basic terms that can help you in various situations. Because Polish is not an easy language, all of the phrases you will learn in this video are in their simplest and commonly used form. Thanks to that you will be able to easily use them and the Poles for sure will understand you. In tourist areas of Poland, English is generally all you need. But if you want to get to know Poland from more local perspective or just feel more secure in any situation, watch until the very end. You watch this video, so I believe very useful can be nie mówię po polsku or nie rozumiem. But don't give up. You can learn a few more. When you want to say hi, use cześć. But the more formal phrase to use to people we see for the first time is dzień dobry or after sunset dobry wieczór. In the same situation that you use excuse me or I'm sorry, you can use przepraszam. As yes, say tak. As no, say nie. By the way, word no pronounced in this way, no, in Polish means yes. However, it's super casual, so it's better to use tak. When ordering a meal in a restaurant, you can say poproszę. For example, poproszę pierogi. A pronunciation of some of the most popular dishes you might want to try while in Poland is żurek, barszcz, pierogi, it's plural, gołąbki, bigos, gulasz, pączek. Don't take only one, say cztery pączki. Łazanki, kotlet, kiełbasa. Probably you want also drink. Woda, kawa, herbata, piwo, wino, wódka. And here is some example of simplification. We often conjugate nouns, so if you want to be super correct, you should say poproszę wodę instead of poproszę woda. However, in the menu you will find a noun in base form, woda, and if you will use this form, I'm sure everyone will be okay with that. Ah, and of course you can use poproszę whenever you ask for something in any other situation. For example, poproszę kilogram jabłek or poproszę kilo jabłek. We often shorten words kilogram or dekagram to kilo or deko. By the way, on daily basis we use only metric system. Giving values in pounds, foods or gallons will certainly not be clear to Poles. And by the way too, Poland is the biggest apple producer in the European Union. When you will visit local market, for sure you should buy some. We have a lot of different kinds of this fruit. All of them are super tasty. When you want to say thank you, say dziękuję or bardzo dziękuję. You will probably hear as response proszę. You are looking for specific place or street, say gdzie jest. Gdzie jest toaleta? So you can use gdzie jest if the question is about a place that is rather not far away. If the place is more distant and you need to go there either by walking or by taking a ride, you can say jak dojdę do ulicy Świętego Tomasza if you want to walk there, jak dojadę do ulicy Świętego Tomasza if you wish to drive or take public transportation. Ulica means street. In Poland you will often see the abbreviation ul with dot at the end, but we always pronounce it in full form ulica, and ul without dot at the end it's hive. So pronunciation of the shortened form can be misleading. Ah, and SW is abbreviation for święty. Few places that you may want to go is probably sklep, bankomat, targ, dworzec kolejowy, dworzec autobusowy, przystanek autobusowy, toaleta, zamek, kantor, lotnisko, apteka, kasa biletowa. And I hope no, szpital. By the way, emergency number in Poland is 112. It's one number for police, hospital and fire service, used only in emergency situations. As a directions to get there, you will probably hear cały czas prosto, na skrzyżowaniu, skręć w lewo, skręć w prawo, or just prosto, lewo, prawo. At the end you may hear po lewej stronie, po prawej stronie. You want to know price? Ask ile to kosztuje. You are not sure what someone said? You can ask, możesz napisać? You want to pay? Use. Zapłacę kartą or zapłacę gotówką. As goodbye you may say cześć. More formal is do widzenia or after sunset dobranoc. If you took your other half to romantic dinner, don't forget to say kocham cię. For some more phrases, check the links to the channels in the description. There you will find a lot of useful Polish lessons. For more trip advices, check my playlist. Subscribe for more!